They're going to be around for lifetimes, and they're accumulating. So we not only have to be concerned about what that means for us, but what does it mean for our children and our grandchildren?
11 News Investigates obtained some new research before it's even published, with troubling implications for all Maryland residents. A first-of-its-kind study found every single Marylander tested had toxic forever chemicals in their blood, nearly all of them with enough contamination to warrant health screenings with their doctors.
In part one of our exclusive series, Toxic Legacy, investigative reporter Tali Taylor looks at what this pioneering research means for residents across the state.
The study volunteers had no specific reason to think they had been exposed. But what researchers found was high levels of PFAS contamination in their blood. So even with a small sample size, researchers say it's clear these toxic chemicals are making their way into Maryland residents, resulting in numerous potential health problems.
Toxic forever chemicals found in the blood of every Maryland resident tested. 41 volunteers from every part of the state. And as 11 News Investigates would come to find out, if it's in your blood, it can make you question everything.
Do you feel like there are any conclusions you can draw that you feel confident about?
And most people in Maryland have these in their blood.
Over the summer, Johns Hopkins University professor Dr. Anna Rule partnered with the Maryland Pesticide Education Network for this study, with the final results from the lab coming back in January.
They were especially interested in whether two forever chemicals, PFOS and PFOA, showed up in people's blood. Because in April, for the first time ever, the federal government established a legal limit for them in tap water, 4 parts per trillion.
Yeah, we were pretty surprised that more than 50% are above that.
In other words, more than half of Marylanders tested had levels of these two chemicals in their blood above the federal limit.
What are some of the highest levels that you saw?
I think we had someone who came in at like over 42 or 43, something like that.
That's more than 10 times the legal limit, despite the fact that the people tested had no known exposure to these chemicals. So why does that nationwide limit exist? Because extensive research has linked both types of PFAS to cancers, kidney and liver damage, pregnancy complications, and other health problems.
What was your reaction to hearing the results?
I was alarmed.
For the decades they were used in manufacturing, PFOS and PFOA could be found in the air you breathe, the water you drink, and the pots and pans you cook with. But even after one was outlawed in 2002 and the other in 2015, Dr. Rule says these chemicals persist in our world because they're nearly indestructible. As 11 News Investigates was first to reveal in the fall, dozens of schools across the state discovered illegal levels of PFAS in their water.
I think we just didn't know the extent of the contamination.
Bonnie Raindrop and Sean Lynch wanted to pursue this study because they're trying to get the state to ban more than 1,000 pesticides that use PFAS as an active ingredient. And they're not just used to spray crops.
And when you think about the fact that these pesticides are used indoors, in our homes, in schools, healthcare facilities.
Even Maryland Attorney General Anthony Brown has gotten involved. Because for a long time, PFAS were used in our clothes. The AG filing suit against the manufacturer of Gore-Tex,
accusing the company of polluting the air and water around 13 facilities in Maryland with PFAS, stating Gore should be responsible for the cost of investigation, treatment, and cleanup, not taxpayers. The complaint alleges the waterproof clothing manufacturer knew for decades that PFOA was toxic and posed significant risks to human health, and would remain in the environment for hundreds of years, leaving a toxic legacy for generations to come.
I just got my results back the other day, and I was concerned because, the numbers were around 8.
In the middle of our interview, something unexpected. Raindrop sharing that because the study showed such high levels of PFAS in the blood of Maryland residents, she got herself tested.
You had your blood tested?
Yes.
And you found an 8 for PFOA and PFOS?
Yes.
Those are the two that have had the most extensive studies, that have had the most direct links to different types of cancers?
Yes.
And you have an 8, which is double the federal limit?
Yes.
The study, scientific and precise, crossing over into the personal and unknown.
And on a very human level, what was your reaction to that?
I need to learn more. I need to understand more about what that means. Of course, I'm very concerned because last year I was diagnosed with cancer. So, you know, it has a very real impact for me.
Raindrop received her PFAS results on New Year's Eve, months after being diagnosed with cancer. And now a question lingers in her mind. Did one cause the other?
And you find that you have double the federal limit in your blood, and you also have this cancer diagnosis. Just for anyone else out there who's watching this, what's your message to them about your situation and about these PFAS in the environment?
You know, it's a tough question to answer because I try to live a very healthy lifestyle. I try to eat clean. I try to limit my exposure to chemicals. But the fact is that we all live in a very toxic world. A beautiful world, but a toxic world.
W.L. Gore says in a statement that they deny the allegations in that lawsuit, and I'll have more on that lawsuit soon. Tomorrow, new at 5, I'll have part 2 in our 11 News Investigates exclusive Toxic Legacy, my interview with state lawmakers who are trying to get pesticides with PFAS banned in Maryland. For 11 News Investigates, I'm Tali Taylor.